EAG-Canada is available to Conestoga via a market research company that offers us the use of software called Allocate. The software is a very powerful tool that helps you analyze geographic areas, for example, a province, a city, or even areas of a city, such as the postal codes, to understand what types of people live where, including their demographics and expenditures. Generally, you can use it in two ways. First, to start with a geographic area of interest and figure out what types of people live in that area. Or secondly, to start with types of people of interest to you and figure out where they are concentrated. This is often applied for direct marketing to discover which postal codes are most desirable to market to. The software is available in the Library Resource Center only. Please ask at the front desk to sign out a laptop loaded with EAG Canada. This tutorial will take you through 5 basic steps to creating an output using the software. The first step, pick geographic areas to analyze. Secondly, pick demographic and expenditure details of interest. Choose the file type and style of output. Save your output selections for later use. And finally, click Finish to retrieve statistics. The first decision you must make is deciding what geographic areas you wish to analyze. You will see familiar types of geographic areas like Canada, province, postal code. You have to choose the best level of geography for your research. For example, use the province folder if you want statistics for all of Ontario. For example, what is the average household income in Ontario? This will report a single statistic for the entire province. If you wanted to know about Kitchener, you wouldn't choose this geography, even though it's in Ontario. You'd probably choose census subdivision, then find Kitchener. Similarly, if you wanted to know where people with the highest household income live in Kitchener, you wouldn't choose the Kitchener census subdivision because it reports on all of Kitchener, not areas within it. In this case, you'd probably choose to look at postal codes. To find all postal codes for a location, like Kitchener, use the search tool found under the file menu. Type in Kitchener and select geography type, postal code. You can then add all the Kitchener postal codes and later on observe differences and pick out postal codes that best match the type of people you're interested in. There's also the possibility of creating a custom geographic area. This is useful when you're analyzing a particular location, for instance, a business location, to determine what types of people live near it. You can select a circumference around that location and report on the households within it. The second step is to choose an output type. There are 2 possibilities: file or report. If you are looking at 25 or less geographic areas, for example, individual cities or individual postal codes, use the report option. It looks nicer. Otherwise, use the file option. Because we've already selected postal codes amounting to many more than 25, we'll choose file in this demonstration. It's important to make sure you're saving as an Excel file. The third step is to choose your variables. The word variables basically means the characteristics of people that you want to know more about. There are several categories to consider. Base data set. This folder includes the very basic demographic variables, total population and total households, which will be important if you want to calculate average per household per year. Demographic demo stats. This folder includes more detailed demographic variables, including age, income, family type, etc. Financial household spend. This folder provides variables on a wide variety of expenditure categories and can be quite detailed. All statistics are in total dollars spent per geographic area, meaning that you receive a statistic that multiplies the average dollars spent per household by the number of households in the geographic area you've selected. This effectively provides the market size for the expenditure category. Segmentation, Prism 5. EAG-Canada provides segmented consumer groups on which you can report. Each postal code in Canada is assigned a single segment group to represent it. So, rather than selecting a variety of individual demographic variables, you could instead choose one or more population segments which match your target consumer. Step 4. In step 2, you created a save location for your statistical output file or report. However, there is a second important save you should make. You have the option to save the selections you've made in all the previous steps, called your workspace, so that you can return and open your workspace design at a later date. This is helpful if you do not have enough time to complete your analysis in one sitting. To save your workspace as an allocate file, use the Workspace tab and select File. Then click Save As and choose a location to store the workspace file. Step 5. When you have finished making all your selections on tabs 1 to 4, press the Finish button at the bottom of the Allocate interface. My example used the file format on the Output tab. Because of that, I received an unformatted file that requires some interpretation. In particular, you will need to retitle the coded column headers using the associated desc.txt file, which will be found in the same place you choose to store your output. Now you need to interpret the information. Your strategy is up to you. Which postal codes are most desirable for direct marketing your product or service? Filter and sort the Excel table to narrow the list down. Mapping EAG Canada data. As we've seen, EAG Canada can report statistics on geographic areas, but it won't show you a map of your information. One helpful tool is a website called Batch Geo. It's free to use. Using it, you can input your Excel spreadsheet of information, and Batch Geo will create a map that shows where there are concentrations of postal codes. A warning though, it can take a while to process your file, so be patient. Hopefully, this tutorial helps you understand the power of the EAG-Canada data.